Black Mesa. AJ Schreck, we're back at Pato. And on the meantime, what we're going to do is we're going to find a couple other petroglyphs that I believe to be some of the best petroglyphs in South, in the whole entire Southwest. And one thing about Agua Fria, when you see the wires, what you're going to see is that they track a lot of ruins. So if you're near wires, there's a pretty damn good chance that you're going to be in a place where there are ancient ruins and petroglyph sites. So come along, let's have a good time today, let's have fun. It's good. It's a little brisk, but it's going to be a nice day. It's going to be a beautiful day today. Jay Schreck, Black Flag, let's hit the trail. Falling. No falling is allowed. Some of the best, I'd say these are the most, I call these the best, that we're going to see the best two petroglyphs in the Southwest today, in the same area. I love that deer, though. You don't see, there's only a couple deers that big here. And then Supernova. So we have Supernova 1 right here, right there, and they believe that the circles around it are space, right? And then that would have been the sun eclipsing out right here in the center. Now the second supernova is up here. Right there on that wall right there. And then the one that everybody believes to be the big one is right here. And that's supposed to be the nebulous and the solar system right there. And there's nothing out here like that in any other petroglyph. I've never seen anything that is anywhere close to that, which is incredible. And then that deer there is unbelievable right here. They were all over these walls. You know, there's so many on that one, you can't even really see any of them. And I don't know if I thought that was those shamans' little rock shelter or not, if that's not it. Yeah. I heard an old shit rock. This whole entire wall is pretty spectacular, and we're missing a lot of the stuff that, you know, just weathered. You know, again, if you see branches of any weeds or trees, make sure you peel them off if they're. But if you look down in here and you look at that entire rock has been smoothed out. So they've grinded there. So, you know, we're basically in a small kitchen right there. Look at that one right there. And then the water, the Tinajas is down below. So that's one of the reasons they would have been in this area. You saw the supernova, Wendy.
I did. That was some coolness there. Very cool.
So that the circle is the finger loop to an atlatl, and then the long line is the stick where they put the dart in and hunted sheep and deer out here.
Oh, there's the, is that, maybe that's the rock shelter I was thinking. Look at that little guy there. See, I love the little ones right there by your right hand, by your right hand over the right, oh, right, yeah. There. Yeah. I love that. I love the little, Yeah, the little humans. Yeah, there are two red deer there. They definitely were painted. Deer's all over this area up here. And there's a guy right there on that rock. Those were definitely red one time. There's our favorite guy that you see out here. Lots of dots, so a lot. You see some of these over at Pato as well as here. I love these dots, though. The amount of time somebody would have spent on that is incredible. What do you think, Tim?
Freaking awesome. There's a, around this corner, there's a couple of like, it looks like a queue.
Yeah.
I don't know what it means, but it's different.
You see them grinding all over these stones.
Yeah, I know, it's crazy. Well, that, this flat rock right in front of you, right?
Oh, yeah, it's been just beat down, hasn't it? And you know, there's the Tinos right there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, right in that. That's one of them. It's not.
Wait, is Rattlesnake right here then?
No, Rattlesnake's over there on the other side of the wires.
Over here.
No, Potter's right here.
Oh. I thought they were on opposite sides of each other.
They are in the creek, because then the creek runs that way,
okay.
Splits them, because there's two creeks that run together.
Okay.
They Y in.
Okay.
Secret place, because it's, you know, it's just special. There's stuff here that you don't see anywhere else. You know, here's the supernova, and there's not just one. There are three petroglyphs that deal with that event that people believe the Chinese documented that. So what would you have thought if you was an ancient here? Looking at the sky growing dark and being strange for 30 days, how incredible that would have been. Now, anytime you see ancients, the first thing you're going to realize is they're going to be close to water. And so they did have their own Tinos, and you saw the kitchen above. It's incredible. It really is just an incredible place. It's cool to be able to take people out here because it's something that the average person does never get to see. And this is just starting the day. We got tons of stuff to show people today in this special place, a special location in Agua Fria called Pato, which means in Spanish the duck, because if you stay around long enough you'll see these Tinos and you'll actually see ducks fly in. And we're going to go find the most elusive petroglyph is the duck. Not by far the coolest, but definitely the most elusive. Start seeing all kinds of stuff as you come through here. There was a lot of different communities at Pato. It wasn't just one. Now all of a sudden you're starting to see mass quantities of shards, and you're starting to see ruins here as you come up here. And this was a massive area, very large. So all through here there's going to be all kinds of different stuff that you see. So here is, now as we always notice, is there's each of the corners, or they dig the corners, the pod hunters dug the corners. So if you look through here, you're going to see all kinds of different ruins through here, and there's massive amounts of ruin sites all the way through here as you work your way through. Staying off the walls. It's a nice wall right there. There's another massive ruined site over there as we dig our way through here.